A very good evening, everyone. Welcome, Choir of the Earth, to our latest course and the first in our Season for Peace this year. Welcome, everyone, to a Mass for Peace, known as The Armed Man by Sir Karl Jenkins. We're so excited to be starting this new course today, and I know we've got lots of people joining us from all over the world who are going to learn this with me over the course of the coming weeks. We've got 6 weeks of rehearsals, everyone, to really get to know this piece so very well. And then you're all going to record it and send it in. We will then mix it with the incredible tracks that we've got to share with you, played by Richard Gowers, sung by the Fieri Consort. A very, very special course. Tissues at the ready tonight, everyone. The music is sublime. The performances are the best I've ever heard. And that's just the guide tracks. So there we are. So pleased to welcome hundreds of you. And I'm looking forward to welcoming you all by name in just a moment. For those of you who don't know me, because I know we've got some new people along tonight, a very good evening to you. My name is Ben. It is my huge pleasure and privilege to be the musical director of this choir. I've been its conductor since its very first rehearsal back in March of 2020, very nearly 2 years ago to the day. We started work on a little piece called Handel's Messiah, which we recorded in lockdown. And don't mind saying, it changed my life. It changed the life of many, many people watching tonight. And it was seen around the world, a true inspirational performance. Well, it is fantastic to be back in front of you for our brand new piece tonight. And I shall be playing you some of, well, I was going to say the very best. They're all wonderful. I shall play you a selection of movements tonight to really get you excited about this. And I know we've got some people who aren't sure. Maybe they're along tonight to listen in. Maybe I will, maybe I won't. Well, as soon as you hear the Fieri Consort singing, I'm certain you'll want to be part of this amazing course. But as always, I just need a few moments, everyone, please, to just check that the sound is working. It's become a little bit of a ritual on my part. Those of you that know this this particular way of working, know it's actually very, very important to check that the sound works. Because the last thing I want to do is say, and here's this lovely piece, press a button, and nothing happens. Has that happened before? Oh, yes. After the piano's working, we've got the gorgeous Fieri Consort. Let's have a little bit. Let's have the start of the Agnus Dei just to check the sound levels. This, of course, is Richard Gowers. Okay, I'm officially a puddle already. I hadn't even started yet. Fabulous. Let's have a little bit of L'Homme Armé. I'll be talking about this tune in a minute. There we go. Great stuff. So I think everything's working. I've got the ability to change levels if I need to. We've got enough light, just about. Marvellous. Well, I have a few minutes then to welcome you all before we start at 5 o'clock. So as I say, if you are completely new, if this is your first time at one of these events, maybe you joined us for that fantastic God Save the Queen with Ralph last week. Well, you are very, very welcome. Those of you who are new, please consider subscribing to the channel because we want to get to 6,000 subscribers. So do please click that red button and you'll get notified whenever we go online. And to those of you watching this later on, because I know there's lots of people who have signed up to do this course but can't make it today. For whatever reason, they're busy. We're all busy now. You know, we all have our lives back in some way or another. So to those of you watching later on, hello to you. Hope you enjoy this. I can't wait to get started on this course. Hello to everyone who's watching but not in the live chat at the moment. If you are here and it's one of your first times and you're not chatting away with the lovely people here on my left as well, please do pop up and say hello. They are a very, very friendly choir. Very friendly indeed. The yellow box, well, that is my fantastic colleague Mark. Now, there are two Marks who work for this choir. There's Mark with a K and there's Mark with a C. And Mark with a K is the founder of the choir. And he, at the moment, I believe that about this point, is probably halfway down an Alp strapped to a set of skis. Now, Let's hope he's taking care. I'm sure he is. He's having a well-deserved holiday. He'll be back at the end of this week, and he'll be with us from the start of next week. So my wonderful colleague Mark with a C, Mark Cease, is here tonight in the booth. Hello, Mark. Thank you for all of the hard work you've put in to getting this course up and ready. And I hope you've, all those of you watching, have got your Universal Links, that all-important document, that central location where you can get all of the links, all the information you need to take part in this course. So there we are. Voluntarily, he's not being punished, says Nikki. Absolutely. Well, who would find skiing a punishment? Some people, I suppose. Well, let me see. Who is here? Wow. Huge turnout. And there's people who I haven't seen since last year. So if you're one of them, if you've come back and I haven't seen you since last year, well, I hope you're very well. It's lovely to see you. Now, I'm going to try and get down the list. I'm not going to manage it in one breath. I know I'm relatively good at taking a deep breath, but there's so many people. I shall take my time and welcome you all. So a very good evening, Atti. Hello, Alexandra, our poet laureate. Hello, Alison. Hola to Anna and Jota. Hello, Andrew. Hello, Andy. Good evening, Angela. Hello, Angela. Hello to Anna. Hello, Anne. Hello, Babs. Hello to Barbara. Hello, Barbara and Barbara. We have three Barbaras. I think Barbara will be along in a minute. Hello, Bigot. Hello to Brenda. Hello to Carolyn Rob. Good evening, Carol. Hello, Carolyn. Hello, Carolyn. Hello, Catherine. Hello, Kathy. Hello, Christine. Hello, Christine. And hello, Christine. Three of you here. Christine, I know, was coming along as well. Hello, Claire. Hello to Dave and Jill. I see Anne's just popped up. Hello, Anne. Now I'm going to scroll down. Hello to Denise. Good evening to Diane and George. Hello, Eileen. Good evening, Elizabeth. Hello, Emma. Hello, Fiona. Hello to Frida. A very, very good morning. Goodness me, Jeffrey. That is very, very early. Jeffrey in Australia, thank you for joining us at what must be 5 o'clock in the morning. Hello to George. Hello, Jill. Hello, Gillian. Hello, Epi. Hello, Hillary. Good evening, Hildegard. Hello to Ian and Margaret. Hello, Iris. Hello, Jackie and Gwen. Hello to Jackie. Hello, Janet. Hello, Janet. Hello, Jean. Hello, Jean. Hello, Jennifer. Good evening, Jenny. Hello, Jill. Hello, Jill. Hello, Joe and Joy. And Judy and Judith. And Judy and Julie. Hello, Kate. Hello, Catherine. Hello to Kay and Kitty and Leonora and Leslie. It's moving quite quickly now, so I'm going to have to speed up. Hello to Linda and Linda and Liz and Lisa and Lisa and Liz and Kay. I hate to miss anyone off, so I'm just quickly scanning the list. Hello, Lucy. Hello, Lynn. Hello to Linda. Hello, Margaret. Hello, Margaret and Marion and Marion and Mary and Mary and Marianne and Mike and Nancy. Hello, Nicola. Hello, Nikki. Hello, Pam. Hello, Pascal and Paul and Nancy and Philomena and Pippa and Rebecca and Richard and Robert and Jean and Rosalind and Rosie and Rowena. Hello, Ruth. Hello, Sally. Hello, Sandra. Hello, Sandra. Hello, Sarah. Hello, Shirley. Hello, Simon. Hello, Stefan. Hello to Sue. Hello, Sue Ellen. Hello, Susan. Hello, Suzanne and Suzanne. Hello, Terry. Hello, Jane and Ulla. Hello, Vanessa. Hello, Wendy. Oh, I hate to miss anyone off, but if you are, see Abigail's at the top of the list. Hello, Abigail and Julie and Gloria, who is unarmed and unnamed. Well, there we are, Gloria. I spotted you. Hello, Susan. And to everyone, it's great to see you. And hello, Ingrid. Fabulous. Well, everyone, it is great to see all of you this evening, and Alina's here as well, and Sally. As people are signing in, it is great to have you with us. Now, do enjoy the session this evening. If you're joining us, and this, as this is a public-facing session, this obviously is Choir of the Earth. We are about to embark on a wonderful project. We're going to be singing Sir Karl Jenkins' A Mass for Peace, The Armed Man. And tonight is our first rehearsal. We're going to listen to some of the lead tracks that Fieri Consort and Richard Gowers have prepared for us, and then of course we're starting rehearsals tomorrow. So do enjoy, do make sure you've got a drink of water handy so you can stay hydrated. It is very important, and we should get started. Here we go. A very good evening, Choir of the Earth. Thank you so much for joining me for a very, very special piece. This is the first in a season of works that we're going to put together under the umbrella of Peace on Earth, Peace of the Earth. We're going to be singing music until well into the autumn this year, all under the theme of peace. Now, when Mark and I chose this work last year, we had no idea what was going to happen in our world. We chose it as a way of starting the new year off with a bit of beauty, really. And then, of course, that dratted COVID came and hit us with a new variant, and we decided to change that for the Mozart. But he thought this would be a lovely piece to sing in the spring, again, with no idea what was round the corner. This work has now become essential. It's now become a pivotal part of our output this year, and I do hope you are all looking forward to it as much as we are. Now, over the next 6 weeks, bear in mind there is a week in the middle, you'll have seen from your Universal Link document, there is a week around the Easter break here in the UK where we will take a break, but there's 6 weeks of rehearsals in total. We will be learning this lovely, lovely piece. Now, I hope you've all got your scores, because obviously we don't have a free digital version. This is a very, very new piece. It's very modern. It was written in 1999, performed for the first time in 2000. So please make sure you've got your score, because we will obviously be referring to it throughout. Now, this week, the plan is we're going to start at the beginning. A very good place to start. We're going to learn the first movement and the second movement. So that is L'Homme and Kyrie. But tonight, I thought, well, as along with playing those movements for you so you can get an idea of what we're learning this week, I thought I'd play you some of the other movements in this work, because it is also absolutely lovely, and the Fieri Consort and Richard Gowers have done an amazing job of recording for us. Now, before we start, this piece is based on a very, very, very famous tune. In fact, I was taught about the L'Homme Armé when I went to university here in Bristol. And it was introduced to me by one of my lecturers as the world's most successful pop tune. Now, those of us in the UK will remember there were two particular pop tunes. There was that Bryan Adams song, the Robin Hood one, and then there was the Wet, Wet, Wet version of Love Is All Around in the charts at number one for 16 weeks. You thought that was a long time to be popular. Well, L'Homme Armé is the world's most popular tune for the longest period of time. It was the number one song for the troubadours, these travelling minstrels, to sing during the medieval period. So really, throughout the 14th and 15th century, L'Homme Armé was the tune. And it was the case that many composers in the medieval and early Renaissance period used this tune, which you'll hear in a minute, used this tune as the basis for many sacred works. And it got to the point where a number of people in the Catholic Church got a bit fed up with this, and for various reasons, called something called the Council of Trent, which basically banned stuff like this in sacred music. Didn't stop composers using it, but they had to become clever about it. Now, this wonderful, wonderful piece was commissioned by the Royal Armouries here in the UK, was written in 1999 and first performed in the year 2000. And it is an anti-war piece, without doubt. I mean, not only does it have a dove on the cover, just wait till you get into learning it. It is, as I say, an essential piece for us at this time. It's lots of people calling out, lots of composers. Andrea Josquin, absolutely. Guillaume Dufay, so many composers. I think there are 40 settings of the Mass which uses the armed man, L'Homme Armé, as the basis of its tune. But before we get to that, I think what we should do, everyone, is to put the scores down and to warm ourselves up a little bit, because some of us will want to sing along. If you don't want to sing along, you can absolutely listen along and enjoy every bar of this gorgeous music, but let's all warm up together. So can I invite you, please, everyone, to stand up, or as I like to say, to be upstanding. Thank you very much indeed. And if you are standing this evening, plant your feet, your shoulders width apart. So have a look down at your feet. Make sure they're not too close together. Make sure they're spaced your shoulders width apart and you're feeling good and sturdy as you stand there. Maybe even swing your hips left and right and allow that weight to settle so you feel your weight pressing down into the floor. Wonderful. Make sure your knees aren't locked, so you've got a little bit of give in your knees so the beautiful music can push you around and you can move as you need to. Now, quite a few people won't be standing for various reasons. It's not a problem. But if you could sit up straight in your chair, that would be fantastic. Lots of people saying in the comments that they've sung this one before. Well, then I'm going to be relying on you. You're going to be my experts. But this is the first time I've conducted this. I'm really excited. And those of you who've never sung it before, well, we'll all be in the same boat together. So we're all going to stand up or sit up with a nice straight back and a lovely long neck. And I'm going to ask you all to take some nice deep breaths in and out, just in your own time. Deep, deep breaths that fill your lungs. And as you breathe out, breathe all the air out. And as you breathe in, I'd like to invite you to breathe as if singing with friends, because you are. And as you breathe out, blow all the air away from you. Let it carry away any tension, any stress. So you're relaxing. So let's breathe in. And breathe out. And breathe in. And blow the air away from you. Carrying away any tension, any stress. And one more really deep breath in. Really fill up. And now sigh, everyone. Ah. Wonderful. Let's do that again. Breathe in. And a really heartfelt sigh. Here we go. Ah. Feels really good to sigh. I see some people are listening on the train. No problem. I shall excuse you from standing, but maybe a few deep breaths if you don't mind. And we'll just roll our shoulders round a little bit, ladies and gents. And we're going to roll them back the other way, nice and slowly. Excellent. And then bring your shoulders up to your ears. Deep breath. And as you breathe out, let your shoulders fall and relax. Splendid. And just gently roll your head around a little bit. Good. Fabulous. Well done, everyone. Well, we'll do a little bit of gentle humming just to warm our voices up. Now, if it's late in the day where you are and you've been talking, your voice is almost certainly quite warm. But if it's first thing in the morning or you've not done much talking today, let's all hum this together. So I'm going to give myself a bit of an acoustic and we're going to hum together. Deep breath. Here we go. Upper semitone. And again. And ooh. And again. Ooh. And oh. And an F egg with a tall mouth. Lovely. Now, basses and altos, you might want to drop down the octave after me, everyone, please. Lovely. Brilliant job. Now, before we look at any of the movements, I'd like to just look at one little bit. And if you have your score, if you'd like to sing this with the score, you don't have to. But I thought we could just sing the last bars of the Agnus Dei, which you will find in the score, page 83. Last system, last few bars. This, for me, is the whole point of what we're doing. And you have this lovely line that goes... Dona nobis pacem, give us peace. So, it goes down the scale... together as smoothly and as gently as we can. So I'll count you in. Nice deep breath. One, two, three. Dona nobis pacem. Thank you, everyone. I thought it was important to start with that that very, very, very important sentiment. So let us start off. Let's listen to the first movement. So we'll start at the beginning. As I'm fond of saying, a very good place to start. And we will listen along. Now, those of you who are joining us for the first time, you're very welcome. You're going to hear the accompaniment played on the organ. And our organist is the incredible Richard Gowers, who is a favourite musician for us to work with. He performs, well, he's an amazing organist, pianist, arranger. He was also a singer, a chorister at King's College, Cambridge. He sang the once enrolled David City solo when he was, I think he was 8 or 9. So he is a phenomenal musician. So the organ parts are played by him and the voices are by the Fieri Consort, an amazing group based in London who do so many of our guide tracks for us. Now, we're going to start off, as I say, with La Malmaie. Now, this tune, as I say, it's very, very old. It's from the 14th century. And as you go along, just listen. What does it sound like to you? Okay, as a piece, how would you describe the shape of this melody? And we'll talk about it in a minute. But here is The Armed Man. Here we go, starting on page one. This is bar 7. So this is the bottom of the page, 2, 3, 4. Trumpets. So we will be recording the tapping. I'll talk about that in a minute. As I said, we will be recording this percussion part along. You're going to help us with that. So here is letter D here. That's the trumpet stop on the organ. It sounds fantastic. Soprano. toes. Tenors and basses. Ladies and gentlemen, now you are the first people in the world to hear that recording, other than myself and a small number of people here at Choir of the Earth Tower. So I hope you enjoyed it. Isn't it a fantastic recording? And we will be, of course, learning all of those parts in sectional rehearsals this week. This will be the first movement that we're going to learn. And over the course of the coming 6 weeks, we're going to learn the whole thing. Now, as I said, that tune, that very, very catchy tune, which itself, I guarantee you will be singing to yourself and whistling as you go about your day. What does it sound like to you? Well, some people have said it sounds, I saw that in the comments, it sounds like fanfares and so on. And I think that's where it comes from. Lots of the analysis of this piece, because it's quite hard, obviously, to look back at the 14th century and say who came up with this tune. But it seems to be some combination of a bugle call and a street cry that gives it that very, very recognisable sound. And when you listen to these masses of the medieval and early Renaissance period, you will start to spot that tune hidden in what they used to call a cantus firmus, which is where you take the tune, you slow it right down, you put one note per bar and you write music around it. And that's how they managed to hide this tune in all of these sacred works, but clearly not well enough because the church caught them at it. So there we are, everyone. That is the first movement. We'll be learning that one this week, along with the Kyrie. But before we look at the Kyrie, which is gorgeous and quite long and has quite a lot of that Renaissance, slightly late medieval feel to it. It's got a lovely bit in the middle, which is to be sung in the style of Palestrina. Let's jump ahead a little bit. I'd like to play you the Agnus Dei. And I do know that some people are going to find this very moving. I know I do. But this is for those of you who are coming along tonight and aren't sure whether or not you want to be part of this course. And I completely understand. We're all busy. Those of you that have sung it before, I can understand why you might think, nah, I might give it a miss. But then again, this is Choir of the Earth. You can sing on every single track. This is a brand new recording. This is a chance to be some part of something very, very special. So let's look at the Agnus Dei and we'll sing this through. We're not doing this for some weeks yet, so this is very much a preview. Turn to page 78 in your scores, everyone. Hankies out, as Sandra says. At this point, it's kind of my duty to point out that Choir of the Earth branded hankies are available to buy. So you can mop your tears and support the choir. So, but plug over. Page 78, let's enjoy this. And I think this is, again, every time the Fieri Consort records for us, it's better and better. I don't know how they do it, but they have managed to once again, as the Americans would say, to knock it out the park. So here is Agnus Dei. Definitely tissues at the ready. Here we go. Thank you. Doesn't get much better than that, ladies and gentlemen, does it? Gorgeous, gorgeous singing. The lovely playing from Richard. That pulse underneath. So much flow to that beautiful music and so exquisitely sung. Now, I see people are asking who are the singers. Obviously, it is the Fiery Consort. I'm pretty certain that's Lucy Cox on the top line. I think that was Tom singing tenor and Ben singing bass. Not sure about the alto. We will confirm that. It's usually Mark Strawn who's got all those details at his fingertips. So apologies for tonight. We're not able to share that, but we will do at tomorrow night's rehearsal. So we'll make sure we've got that for you there. Isn't it beautiful? Carolyn says, can we do it again? Well, Carolyn, of course, we will be singing that many, many times over the coming weeks. But I want to share even more of this beautiful music. And if we sing it again, we won't have time for the Benedictus, because of course that's the one everyone's waiting for. So let's jump back to the other movement we're looking at this week, and this is a big one. This is Kyrie, which you'll find at the very start. It's page 16 in the score, and it has a beautiful long organ introduction, and this very, very plain, I don't mean plain in any kind of negative sense, a relatively simple, pure line sung by the sopranos. It's said to be an optional solo. Of course, we're going to sing everything, and so please be ready to sing that, sopranos. And of course, altos, you want to sing along with this, you're very welcome to. I did see, before we play this, I did see a question flick past, is this an audio only project? Well, in terms of your contribution, we will be asking you to record audio and send your photo in as well. We're not going to ask you to record video for this one. We've done this before in the past. We've recorded videos for projects, and it ends up being really quite a stressful job to get it all done. You have to think really hard about what you're wearing and so on. And we have learned over the last couple of years, the best results are to really concentrate on a fantastic performance musically. And we will show, when we broadcast the final performance, you'll see your faces up on screen, but there'll be photographs along with beautiful footage of our wonderful planet. So there's not going to be any video required from you, but your wonderful voices. And of course, you can record multiple lines. So many of you will record both soprano and alto. You can do it for various movements if you like. Some of the ladies, I hope, the 10 altos, will come along and sing with that amazing movement, Save Me From Bloody Men, which we'll hear very shortly. Really powerful plain chant. But let's enjoy the Kyrie, Lord Have Mercy, which then goes into a Christe Eleison in the style of Palestrina, that Renaissance genius who sets the world's polyphony really in motion, and then finishing with some more Kyrie. So let's enjoy this. It is absolutely beautiful. And again, we're delighted to have Richard and the Fieri playing and singing for us. So here we are, page 16, movement 3. Here we go. Bottom of page 16. letter B.
Thank you.
There you are, everyone. How's that? What an amazing piece of music. And so glad to read so many comments saying, I think this is my favourite. Now, I also saw comments going, this is slow. This is slower than the Karl Jenkins recording. Well, I look forward over the coming weeks to see the comments turning around and going, do you know what? I was listening to the Karl Jenkins recording. It takes it a bit fast. Now, do remember, of course, we're going to be recording this all individually, but all around the world. And I should be asking you to stagger the breathing so you don't need to be able to sing these phrases through in one breath. You breathe where you need to. And our amazing engineering team will take out all those breaths and create that wonderful, sinewy, sonorous sound that we're after. And just one thing to point out, this is we've gone by Sir Karl's metronome markings. So this is what he clearly intended at the beginning. He may have changed his mind when conducting live, but I wanted our version to sound different. I don't want it to sound like every other version of the Arm Man, which sounds like the recording. This is our version, and we're going by the score, and it's going to be amazing. Just think about all of those gorgeous lines you're going to be able to bring out and really lean on. Altos, you've got a wonderful line with all of those quavers. So there we are. Yes, it's slow, but that gives us a chance to make it sound absolutely glorious. And those of you that just joined me, having done the Mozart Mass in C minor, at least it's not as fast as the Osanna Fugue. Cheers, everyone. There we are. Oh, Judy, bless you. How can you sing and cry? Oh, well, this is the thing. Music is, it's like a hard wire straight to the heart, isn't it? Sometimes music just brings the tears, and that is one of the reasons we do it, isn't it? Well, look, everyone, before we move on and listen to something equally beautiful and just as heartrending, let's have a look at the fourth movement here. And I did catch some comments in the live chat from people going, save me from bloody men, giggle, giggle, giggle. And yes, absolutely. There was the irony of asking Lady Tenors to sing along on this is not lost on me. But of course, we don't have any bloody men in this choir. We have gentlemen. And I shall be asking the gentlemen of the tenors and basses and any ten altos who want to sing with us to record this particularly effective line. It is supposed to be sung in the style of Gregorian chant. That ancient melodic writing. Some of the earliest written music in the Western classical tradition was Gregorian chant. And so we'll do a wonderful rehearsal on this. It'll be in unison because it is a unison work. And I'd like you to follow it along. Now, if you know it, feel free to sing. If you don't, just really let the impact of this melodic writing, of this beautifully set text, really land. Because obviously it's supposed to be, this is a journey throughout history. From that early tune, that 14th century melody, we've just had some Renaissance polyphony. Now we've got medieval plain chant here. So follow it along. Here is Save Me from Bloody Men. Bury your notes if you want to sing along. Here we go.
Be merciful unto me. Mine enemies would gain.
that. Superb singing again from the Fieri Consort. Now, you heard a clap in the middle. Now, there are plenty of opportunities for you to get involved, and indeed for your friends and family who say they can't sing. Now, you and I, we all know that actually anyone can sing. They just need to have the right teacher and the right opportunity to get in touch, to find their voice. But if you have someone who lives with you, or maybe you're friends with, who insists they can't sing, well, maybe they can come along and stamp their feet and clap for us and be part of this incredible mass. Because we're going to be recording separately and individually from your vocal parts. We're going to be recording all of these sound effects and mixing them in. Now, people have already asked in the comments, we are not going to record the call to prayer. We're going to have that recorded for us. Connor is going to ask an imam at a local mosque to record that for us, so we will have that wonderful call to prayer for the second movement. We will not be doing that, but the sound effects, the stamping, the clapping, the tapping, everything. Those of us who sang on the opera course last year and remember the anvil chorus know we are well versed in creating our own sound effects. What's known in the movie business as Foley. We are no strangers to Foley here in the Choir of the Earth. So there we are. Save us from bloody men indeed. Now, let's have a little listen to an incredible movement. Let's turn to page 49, everyone. And we are jumping around throughout the Mass. This week's work, as I've said, is the Armed Man, first movement, and Kyrie, the third movement. That will be the focus of this week's learning. But for those of you who have said are still unsure, I'm not entirely sure about this, then this is an opportunity for you to hear just how good these tracks are and how excited we are to be recording them. So the next movement I'd like to look at is page 49. It's number 7. This is Charge. And this is an amazingly effective piece. Really very, very powerful. Remember, this Mass is an anti-war Mass, but the words were chosen by the Chief Executive of the Royal Armouries here in the UK for the 600th anniversary of the Armouries. And so Sir Karl has set this really brilliantly. We have this fanfare which starts, which again is so effective, played on the organ. Remember as you listen that Richard Gower has recorded all of these in single takes, so he is an amazing, amazing musician. So let's enjoy Charge, which is the 7th movement, and after this, we'll finish our session tonight with the Benedictus, which is just heavenly. So here we go, everyone. Ready? Mount up. Time to charge. Here we go. A.
Here we go.
top of page 57. There, ladies and gentlemen, that is quite something. Those of you that have been with the choir from the beginning know just how amazing Choir of the Earth sounds when it's all put together. That last two pages, 67 and 68, it's going to sound absolutely out of this world in every possible sense. It's going to be an amazing sound. It's also going to be devastating. And that, of course, is the point of this. We will have the last post played professionally for us at that point. So that is at the heart of this mass, the idea of this sort of galloping towards death, towards certain death. And my goodness, that is going to be quite something. So everyone, we've come to the last piece I want to play this evening. I couldn't leave it there. I couldn't leave it with everyone screaming and shouting and the last post. We have to finish tonight with the Benedictus. And if you've, well, if you look Benedictus Karl Jenkins up on YouTube, they all have tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of views. This is the movement that you'll have heard on Classic FM many, many times, I'm sure. And this is page 86, so we're actually going to jump in on page 87, because the whole thing has a beautiful opening. We are going to have a cello line along with Richard's beautiful organ playing. And that alone is going to be just achingly beautiful. But we're going to jump in, everyone, Halfway down page 87. And this is, well, I'm going to choke up conducting it. Benedictus, qui venit in nomine Domini. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. So let me just get this track where I need to be. Bear with me a moment. You'll hear the start of it. Lovely. Thank you, Richard. So we're jumping in partway down, as I say, that second page. Here we go, everyone. Time for the goosebumps. So this is letter C coming up. There you are, folks. That alone, I hope, for those of you who are not yet decided whether or not you want to sing on this course, I hope just hearing that's changed your mind. That track, as it is, without us singing, is glorious. That Fieri consort, as I say, singing at the top of their game. But when you consider that there'll be hundreds and hundreds of people recording that, and our engineering team, who are the best in the world at this, no doubt, our engineering team will mix that, and we will have something absolutely astonishing, something that will send the message of peace out to the world. And I want to finish tonight off, well, I need to thank you all for coming, of course. I'm so looking forward to working with you all this week. Remember, we have rehearsals tomorrow night, then no rehearsals Wednesday and Thursday. Check the Universal link. Rehearsals on Friday, and then two rehearsals on Saturday afternoon. Thank you very much for your flexibility on this. I'm going to be in London on Wednesday and Thursday, but therefore we're going to have those rehearsals on a different day. All back to normal next week with rehearsals on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. But I want to finish by just pointing out something really rather lovely about this choir and about this piece. Other than the fact that I'm so looking forward to singing it with all of you and to teach it to you all. We changed the name of this choir last year. We were founded as the Self-Isolation Choir. And as the world changed, as the virus changed, we changed with it. We became Choir of the Earth. And Choir of the Earth, of course, if you take the initials of each of those words, becomes C-O-T-E, or coat. And, of course, a coat is another name for a little house. Again, something very relevant to us with our little house logo that a dove lives in. And so to our, my wonderful choir, to the wonderful coat, thank you so much for being here tonight. I'm so looking forward to singing this with you. And please tell all your friends, if they were in any doubt, to come and sing this. Those of you on the forum, time to twist a few arms, I think, and say, come on, come and sing this. Because if we could have a choir really the same sort of size as God Save the Queen, you can just imagine the sort of sound we can produce with all these incredible sound effects and so on. So, dear coats, I'm going to show you the logo in a minute. And as you do, I want your heart to be filled with joy and excitement for this amazing course. And remember, this is the first in a season of peace. Peace of the Earth by Choir of the Earth. So I shall see you later this week for your sectional rehearsals. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you, Mark, for all of your help. Thank you, Fieri and Richard. And I look forward to seeing you very, very soon. C-O-T-E. Take care, folks. Bye-bye.